Hey, this is Rick. Today we're going to take a look at a Stratocaster. This is a Tex-Mex Strat. It's a little bit different than maybe your garden variety standard Strat, as it has Tex-Mex pickups. It also has a flame maple top. I hope you can see that in there. It's a real beautiful guitar. The only thing I've done to this one is to trade out the pick guard. It came with a regular white pick guard, and I put this cream perloid pick guard on it. Otherwise, it's the same way it was when I bought it. I bought this down in Killeen, Texas. I was down there doing some Army stuff and just saw it. And number one, it was on sale. Number two, I fell in love with it. So I just really like this one, regular Strat. So let's take a look. Again, three single coil Tex-Mex pickups. We'll start off on this back pickup, the bridge pickup. This one has six saddles, six adjustable saddles, the standard six screw bridge with a tremolo. And right now I have four springs in the back of this one, so I've got some pretty good resistance. Not a whole lot. I want always to come back to center, of course. So let's take a look at this. You know, the Strat's pretty famous for that surfy stuff that came on in the 50s and 60s. Pickup can be nice and bright. You can do some cool stuff with it. Good for biting through the mix, playing in a band with other guys, so you can get your guitar heard without just more volume. A lot of times it's the voicing and the way the pickup sounds that helps you get that sound out. And we'll see how that compared to the other pickup settings here in just a second. So the standard bridge pickup, gonna be kind of bright. A little mystical there, a little judicious use of the tremolo bar. We'll go to the second position, which is the middle and the bridge pickup together. This is kind of a really classic sound that people attribute to Mark Knopfler, which he actually uses a middle pickup a lot too, but this combination of the two back pickups. That's where the term quack comes from. So we'll listen to that quack. I use this setting pickup selection when I'm doing stuff like this. So there's a lot of different times you could have a sound like that. Single note licks, real short, easy runs. Stuff like that, a little prettier. You just get the tone that you're looking for there in that position. My only effects to help get that are just a little bit of delay and reverb on my Vox Tone Lab LE pedal board processor. And I'm running into a Fender Blues Jr., an Egnator Tweaker, and a Vox AC-15. I'm kind of pigtailed into those things. Real nice and easy, not a lot of distortion or anything. Let's go on to the middle pickup with those same clean settings. A middle pickup, like I mentioned in one of my other videos, is really underrated as a lead pickup. Typically, that bridge pickup is one you depending on what type of music you're playing. The bridge pickup might be called a lead pickup. On many guitars it is. On Gibsons, for example, the back pickup is a lead, front's rhythm. And the same on a Telecaster a lot of times. But you get to that middle pickup, it's right in the right spot as far as the string spacing goes with the bridge, the 12th fret, the nut. So where these pickups up are really determine how the sound is. So when we go to this middle pickup, it's something that you don't get on a Telecaster because the pickup's not there, it's up here, right? So what you get is a kind of a good mix between the bright stuff on the bridge and the bluesy stuff on the neck. Well, that middle pickup's going to give you, because they're not wired in combination, you're getting only the middle, but you get a combination of the tones because of where the pickups are in relation to the neck and the strings. Has a little bit of that quacky sound. But it's still more clear and clean. In this case, it's clean. So that's that Tex-Mex pickup in the middle. We'll go to the fourth position. The middle and the front pickup. Again, you get that quacky sound. This time it's not going to be so bright because we're using the neck pickup instead of the bridge pickup. And some of that bridge pickup gets its bite because it's right next to the bridge. The strings don't have enough room to vibrate there to get all of the range of motion, whereas you move it up here closer to the 12th fret where the strings are really doing all their vibrating. It just changes the tone just by the different position where the pickup is. So we're on this position 4, and we're going to see how that quack changes a little bit. That position can also be really good for some rhythm stuff. I'll just do a little nice easy progression to kind of listen for that tone. What people normally associate with like a Stevie Ray Vaughan type tone, where it's just, and Stevie Ray Vaughan got a lot of his tone from his hands and his fingers and his picking and that old beat up Stratocaster he used. But that front position, you can get the basic raw tone out of any Strat that has a decent pickup, and these Tex-Mex pickups are really decent. Tune that I use to help me kind of get an oral picture, a visual picture of my sound, is that little Los Lonely Boys thing on that Henry Garza plays on the Strat. Tone there. It's kind of cold in here. My fingers are not working right. That's what my excuse is today. Pretty much nothing sounds like a Strat on that front pickup position. And it's pretty discernible, pretty easy to pick out if you're a guitar player. We can also do some really cool rhythm stuff on that front pickup because of the tone. Let me see if I can think of something. something to watch out for. It just happened. When I'm getting wild with my picking, sometimes I'll knock my switch position back. So I could tell my tone changed because when I was trying to figure out what to play there, I hit the switch and bumped it back a position. It just means I'm a little too wild with my picking. I'm going to put a little more overdrive on this, and we'll see what these five pickup positions sound like. Really quick, I'll just kind of go through some standard stuff, and you can hear the differences. That's the thing we're listening for, the differences between the tones. So I'll put a little overdrive, a little tube overdrive simulation on the neck pickup stills. So I'll just do a little slow bluesy thing, maybe, so you can hear more of the tones and less of my funky picking today. See you next time.